The Science of the Northern Lights. An aurora, also known as the polar lights, aurora polaris, the northern lights, aurora borealis, or the southern lights, aurora australis, is a natural light display in the sky that is most visible in high-latitude regions around the Arctic and Antarctic. The word aurora comes from Aurora, the Roman goddess of the dawn who wandered from east to west heralding the arrival of the sun. The name was first used symbolically to allude to dawn by ancient Greek poets, who frequently mentioned the movement of colors across the otherwise gloomy sky. Colored lights may occasionally shimmer over the night sky for those who live or visit high latitudes. Some Inuit believed that amid the shimmering aurora, their ancestors' souls may be seen dancing. The aurora was a flaming bridge to the sky erected by the gods in Norse mythology. The aurora borealis or aurora australis, sometimes known as the northern or southern lights, is a stunning natural phenomenon. When charged particles from the sun collide with atoms in the Earth's atmosphere, electrons in the atoms shift to a higher energy state. When electrons return to a lower energy state, they emit a photon, which is light. The aurora borealis or northern lights are produced as a result of this process. Auroras are created by solar wind-induced disruptions in the magnetosphere. Charged particle paths in the magnetosphere plasma are altered by these disruptions. The upper atmosphere, thermosphere, exosphere collects these particles, which are mostly electrons and protons. The ionization and stimulation of air elements that results produce light of various colors and complexity. The degree of acceleration imparted to the precipitating particles also influences the shape of the aurora, which occurs in bands around both polar regions. Auroras can be found on most of the solar system's planets, as well as some natural satellites, brown dwarfs, and even comets. The auroral zone, which is normally 3 degrees to 6 degrees wide in latitude and between 10 degrees and 20 degrees from the geomagnetic poles at all local times, or longitudes, is most easily observed at night against a black sky. The auroral oval, a band shifted by the solar wind towards the night side of Earth, is a location that is currently displaying an aurora. The statistics of auroral observations provided early evidence for a geomagnetic relationship. The aurora appeared mostly in the auroral zone, as established by Elias Loomis, 1860, and later Hermann Fritz, 1881, and Sophus Tromholt, 1881, in more detail. The aurora borealis, often known as the northern lights, is a phenomenon that occurs at higher latitudes. Galileo invented the former word in 1619, combining the Roman goddess of dawn and the Greek name for the north wind. The aurora australis, also known as the southern lights, exhibits properties that are nearly identical to the aurora borealis and moves in lockstep with changes in the northern auroral zone. The aurora australis can be seen in Antarctica, Chile, Argentina, New Zealand, and Australia from high southern latitudes. Alaska, Canada, Iceland, Greenland, Norway, Sweden, and Finland are all close enough to the Arctic Circle to see the aurora borealis. The aurora ovals, north and south, expand as a result of a geomagnetic storm, sending the aurora to lower latitudes. The instantaneous distribution of auroras, the auroral oval, is slightly different, being concentrated approximately 3 to 5 degrees nightward of the magnetic pole, with auroral arcs reaching furthest toward the equator when the magnetic pole in question is between the viewer and the sun. Magnetic midnight is the greatest time to watch the aurora. Auroras visible within the auroral oval may be directly overhead, but from afar, they cast a greenish light, or occasionally a faint crimson, on the poleward horizon, as if the sun were rising from an unexpected direction. Auroras can be seen as diffuse patches or arcs poleward of the auroral zone. The aurora can be seen as curtains of light, arcs, or spirals, and they often follow lines of force in the Earth's magnetic field. The majority are green, although there may be a tint of pink here and there, and strong displays may include red, violet, and white. The northern lights are most commonly observed in the extreme north, in countries surrounding the Arctic Ocean, such as Canada and Alaska, as well as Scandinavian countries, Iceland, Greenland, and Russia. However, in the United States, strong displays of the lights can be seen at lower latitudes. The lights, of course, have a counterpart in the south polar regions of the Earth. Throughout human history, the aurora's colors have been a source of fascination. When gases in the Earth's atmosphere are stimulated, scientists believe they emit different colors. The aurora borealis, for example, are green because of oxygen. Blue and red colors are caused by nitrogen. As a result, the aurora's mystique is no longer as enthralling as it once was. Despite this, people continue to travel thousands of miles to witness the spectacular natural light shows that occur in the Earth's atmosphere. Even if we understand the scientific explanation for the aurora, the spectacular natural light show might inspire us to imagine fire bridges, gods, or dancing spirits.